Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Carbon here, bringing you guys today another brand new video. And today is another exciting day for Black Ops 3, guys. We got a huge update. It is the update 1.13 with a whole bunch of new things, whole bunch of updates. So today I'm going to bring you guys the patch notes for this specific update. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take a look at this. So first off, we have a new game mode called Fracture. Now, I did a video about this just a few minutes ago, so you guys can go ahead and check it out. I explain everything. So for this video, I'll go over the description. So it says here, pick up core files dropped by fallen enemies and deliver them to the Fracture site. Deposit in the core files, earn score for your team. The first team to reach the score limit or the team with the most deposited files at the end of the time limit wins the match. So in my opinion, this is a bit of a mix of, I would say, I don't know, kill confirmed and kind of hard point, capture the flag-ish. You know, it's a bit of a mix, everything. I explained it very well in my other video, so I'll put in the link in the description so you guys can go ahead and check it out. And let's move on. So we have some, you know, updates to specialists and some guns. So specialists, we have Prophet. Prophet's Tempest will now only require one shot to kill an enemy with kinetic armor. And also, Prophet's Temples will now only require one kill to kill an enemy with uplink drone armor active. So, it's a bit of a buff there. And then, Creator class, we have some general fixes. Weapons customized in Gunsmith and assigned in Creator class will no longer lose their camouflage after restarting the application. And then, we have Shotguns, the Banshee. We have reduced weapon damage against score seeks. Now, this gun, I mean, a lot of people say it's OP. In my opinion, I don't think it's OP. I mean, it's a pretty powerful gun, not gonna lie. But you need to, you know, you have to have some skill to use it. So that's my opinion. But the good thing is here is they haven't really nerfed the gun very much. They just, you know, reduced the weapon damage against score streaks, which I don't mind at all. But the weapon is still as deadly to enemies the same like it was before. So nothing to worry, guys. So score streaks, we have GI unit resolved an issue where the robot would self-destruct shortly after landing. So I don't know what's up with that. That's been fixed. And then we have some game mode fixes. We have uplink players can now move freely after the round time limit has ended if the satellite drone is still in the air. So that's good. So safeguard resolved an issue where the safeguard robot walk animation would become corrupted at the start of a round. So yeah, this used to happen to me where the robot would just go insane at the start of the game, and that's been fixed, so which is good. And then let's take a look here. We have some general gameplay fixes. We have fixed for players not getting awarded correct contract bonus and occasionally getting negative awards. Wow, I actually haven't happened to me, but that sounds pretty bad, so that's been fixed. Resolved an issue where picking up drop weapons or the uplink satellite drone would cause the player camera to jitter. Now, this obviously happened to me in the past, especially when you're playing uplink. It happens a lot. When you pick up the drone, your camera just go crazy and just you walk weird. I hope that's been fixed. So that's what they're saying, so which is good. And then we have black market fixes. We have fixed an issue where after completing a daily contract, if the user backed out of the match before it completed, they would receive a non-functional retry button in the black market. Users will not receive their crypto key reward until they complete another match. So make sure you don't back out once the you know, the challenge is completed. They wouldn't award it, I guess. I think I've done this once where it kind of shows like a option to retry or something, and then it would actually give you the crypto keys because you finished it, but you have to completely finish the match, I guess, now. So yeah, be aware, guys. So fix an issue where if a user redeemed all their weapon bribes from their season pass purchase, they were prompted with a purchase button which requires an incorrect crypto key amount. I'm not sure what that is, but I guess that's been fixed. And then we have some general fixes. New breadcrumb support added to playlists when new content or promotions are active. Fix the Energion camo appearing in English in several languages. Fix for lobby leaderboards filtering to friends only. Fix a couple of issues where with the action after action report. One is crypto key progress bar would not animate after contract reward was earned, even if the player earned additional crypto keys just from playing. The other issue was appearance of negative crypto keys in the after action report. Negative crypto keys? Wow, did that actually happen? I have no idea, but it's a good thing they fixed it. Alright, So obviously we have support for the new map packs, which is obvious. So we are getting new maps tomorrow, which is Cryogen, Berserk, Rumble, Empire, and the Zombies map, Garrot Crowy. So these are pretty awesome maps, guys. I did a video on it, so I'll put a link in the description as well, so you guys can go ahead and check it out. So obviously they added support for those. And then let's see what we got here. We have PS4 Play Together section here. So first party functionality support the PSN Play Together feature. Allows players in a PSN party to send an invite to all players in their party. Ooh, that's actually kind of good. Because you can now send invites to all players in your party. So I like that. I like that. That's good. And then let's see if there's anything other important stuff. So we have actually some keyboard support implemented for Codcaster hotkeys. So that's good. Then there's a whole bunch of Codcaster updates, which are not really important. I mean, unless, you know, you guys can read it on your own time. I'll put a link in the description so you guys can go ahead and, you know, read in detail of all these things. And then Arena, actually, we have some good news for Arena. Probation is no longer given to players who leave a match when outnumbered by two or more. So that's pretty good. So if you're outnumbered, if your team decides to leave and you're just by yourself, you can just leave the match and, you know, probation is no longer, you know, given for you, so which is good. And then players will no longer lose stars below rank 5. And then players are now required to find or required to press find match in the arena post-game lobby to start matchmaking. So that's some good fixes there. And then we have some group fixes. So we have the groups option in Black Ops 3 now. Players can now invite players to a group by searching for their player ID. Added the republish to group button in players showcases to easily republish content to any groups joined after the content was created. Increased maximum group membership to 100,000 players. So that's good. Updated recent public groups and friends group to display whether or not group requires a join request, public or group invite, private. Not really sure. I didn't really get that part. I don't know. I don't know anything about groups, guys, but I guess I'm just going to read this for you guys so you guys would understand what I'm talking about. So again, last one, when searching through friends groups, players will now be able to view which of their friends belong to listed groups. So that's good. Alright, so I think that's pretty much it. We have some in-store updates which are not that important. We have some general which we talked about. And obviously we have some updates for all the zombies maps. And also we have some zombies changes as well. So it says zombies changes fix the bug that caused attachment variance to change when pack-a-punch weapons. And then added various alignment fixes for text notifications, removed an incorrect personalized prompt for the new weapon kits menu, and then fixed a bug causing the revive icon to stick to the player's HUD after host migration. Alright, alright guys, so that's pretty much it for this video. I mean, that's pretty much all the updates that I can see here. Obviously, like I said, there are a whole bunch of map fixes, you know, bugs and whatnot, which you guys can go ahead and read in detail. But for tomorrow, I think they're ready to go live with the new map pack, so I'm pretty excited for that. I will definitely bring you guys some, you know, gameplay and some videos on the new maps. So let me know if you guys are interested in, you know, if you guys are excited for the new maps. Let me know if you guys bought the season pass. Do you guys think these maps are going to be awesome? I'm really excited to play on the Raid or the Empire, which is now called the remake of Raid from Black Ops 2. So yeah, again, let me know in the comments what you guys think. And thank you so much for watching. Please give it a thumbs up if you like it. And I will catch you guys in my next video. Peace out, guys.